So say me your sorries. I'm raising the army. Revolutionary warfare with Damian Marley. We sparking the irons, marching the Zion. You know how Nas be, NYC, state of mind, I'm
in this world of calamity. Dirty looks and grudges and jealousy. And police way abuse their majority. Media comes when I know about variety. Single parents that need some charity. Youth that need some love and prosperity. Instead of broken dreams and tragedy. By any plan and any means and strategy. See, I got to keep on walking.
Shalom, salam.
I will make another He-Man, an evil one called Faker. I have done it, a perfect likeness of He-Man. Sometimes my power even amazes me. Faker, you must get the sorceress to leave Grayskull. Outside the castle, her magic is weaker, and I can overpower her.
In the previous segment, we talked about the Antichrist spirit, or that satanic influence, Antichrist spirit, that comes in the likeness of Almighty God, Elohim, but more of a whitewashed version of the actual truth, serving the purpose as a counterfeit version.
I'm sure we're not on the guest list, Skeletor.
Of course not, you stupid But what if we had a magical clone of He-Man?
Well, I suppose, hypothetically.
We do. We have a magical clone of He-Man.
Da-da-da-da!
What the hell is this, Beastman? He's blue.
Well, I'm half dog. Everything's shades of gray to me. Me, He-Man!
And his personal pronouns are all f***ed up. I mean, where's the verb in that sentence? Gah!
So therefore, we have to resurrect the real deal in order to knock out the counterfeit.
Merry Christmas, everybody. And here's my one. Shut up.
That's a perfect example or parable of the blue He-Man and the real deal brown He-Man that's going back to the origin of the true Christ or the true Moshiach, representing the one true God, Elohim, also known through the divine covenant name, you know, Hashem, and the original Hebraic revealed as Yahweh, or Yahweh Jah, Rastafari, representing the resurrection of the true messianic faith of the new covenant, of Yahweh's salvation, or the true Judaic Christian faith, as opposed to counterfeit Christianity or modern corporate Christianity. But as we, two segments ago, went over an ancient Kabbalistic rooted Judaic teaching, in this particular segment we're going to go over an old messianic teaching of Yeshua himself, or of the Messiah himself. Open your word, the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 3. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground, where they did not have much soil. And they sprang up quickly, since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched. And since they had no roots, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil, and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen. Then the disciples came and said to him, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" And Yeshua said to them, "To you it has been given to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given." And if you fast forward to verse 24, Yeshua explains the parable of the weeds. As a matter of fact, let's back it up to verse 18. Verse 18, he says, "Hear the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what is sown in the heart. This is what was sown on the path. As for what was sown on rocky ground, this is the one who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet such a person has no root, but endures only for a while. And when trouble or persecution arises on account of the word," meaning Jah word, "that person immediately falls away. As for what was sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word, but the cares of the world and the lure of wealth choke the word, and it yields nothing. But as for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields in one case 100-fold, in another 60, in another 30.